What is IK, what is FK, and what is the difference between them? Let's find out. If you're new to animation, or are looking for a refresher, you've come across the terms IK and FK. IK stands for inverse kinematics, FK refers to forward kinematics. Both of these are rig systems. A rig is an armature made up of bones that allows anyone to control a character or object with greater ease and a better level of control. Simply put, kinematic deals with aspects of motion. IK, inverse kinematic, FK, forward kinematic. They are just opposite systems that allow an animator to move a rig in different ways. A rig can have both of these systems, that way an animator can choose how they want to work. I'm going to jump into Blender and illustrate both of these points. Here we go. When 3D riggers create a character rig, they base the bone placement off our skeletal system. I'm going to use myself in this example to illustrate the point more clearly. I'm going to snap my fingers and we're going to create a character rig. And like that, I'm rigged. Let's have a look at the rig together. Here on the screen left side, for both my arm and leg, you can see these orange bones. That's our IK system. Everything else in blue is our FK. We're going to start here in the upper arm. If I select my upper arm bone and rotate it, you can see it influences everything to do with the arm. If I go to the elbow, it only affects the elbow to the end of the arm. And if I select the hand, it only rotates the hand. FK is a chain system. The first bone, when rotated, has the most influence. The further you go down that chain, the less influence a bone will have. This last bone, or any bone in the chain, will never affect a bone further up the chain, because it's always forward. So that's forward kinematics, FK. IK is the reverse of that. I can start at the end and influence everything further up the chain. So that's inverse kinematic. That's the easiest way to understand it. If we zoom out a little bit and select my body and just lower my body, you can get an idea also of that systems, both systems working here as well. Here's my IK for the leg, and I can move that. So again, I can start at the very bottom of the chain, and that will influence everything further up the chain. When I move my body on the FK side, there is no inverse kinematic, so there is nothing holding it there. If I wanted to achieve something similar with this pose when moving my body down, I would have to rotate all the chains in that system just to get something similar in my IK shape. So I hope this illustrates the difference between the two. Now we're going to talk about some of the case uses and when you want to use what system, and even talk about some of the switching that you can do. Okay, I'm going to reset my rig. Pretty much most of the time, you're going to use IK for your feet. And by default, most rigs come IK. You want those feet planted on the ground so it's easy to animate. For my upper body, to me, it always remains FK. Unless I'm interacting with any object, my hands will always be in the FK mode. I find that more appealing and easier to work with. So the answer is IK for my feet, FK for my upper body. You can see that even our spine acts in that way as well. So if I were to select this bone, you can see that my influence gets less and less. So I hope that illustrates the difference between the two of them and gives you an idea when to use either the IK or the FK. Let's talk a little bit about the switching. Rigs generally have an IK and FK switch built into their controls, so you can switch between the two systems as you, the animator, want. For me, I found it's easiest to switch between the systems over one frame. So I'll key that attribute on one frame. Over the next frame, I'll key the attribute either on or off. I like to do it over one frame because I have more control over the switch. Let's say my character is jumping through the air and grabs a bar. The frame that that contact happens, I would go from FK to IK. Maybe the character swings around the bar. For those 12 frames, I remain IK. And the second we let go, I switch back to FK. So that's an example of when I would do the switch. Or if I'm standing here, and I'm grabbing a cup off the table, that moment I grab the cup, I switch to IK, do my animation, I release the cup, I'm back in FK. I hope this video helped you understand the difference between IK and FK. If you have any questions, let me know. If you enjoyed the video, please like it so that I know this content was useful. I'm going to leave you with a very terrible animation. Hope you like it. Bye, everyone.